Mary dear, I am most provoked. I've heard that you brought a common flower girl from Covent Garden to my box.
Oh, darling, she'll be all right. I taught her how to speak properly, and she's been instructed as to her behavior. She's to keep the two subjects, the weather and people's health, sort of a fine day and how you do, not to go on about things in general. Oh, help her along, darling, and you'll be quite safe.
Safe? To talk about our health in the middle of a race?
Well, she's got to talk about something.
Henry, you're not even dressed for Ascot.
Oh, Mummy, I changed my shirt.
Where's the girl now?
Being pinned, some of the clothes we bought for her didn't quite fit. I told Pickering we should have taken her with us.
You're a pretty pair of babies playing with your live doll. Ah, Mrs. Unsford here.
Oh, Dan, are all these people here with you?
Mrs. Higgins, is this your celebrated son?
I'm sorry to say that my celebrated son has no manners. He may be the life and soul of the Royal Society soirees, but he's rather trying on more commonplace occasions.
Ah.
Colonel Pickering, you're just in time for tea.
Thank you, Mrs. Higgins. May I introduce Miss Eliza Doolittle?
My dear Miss Doolittle, delighted, my dear. Mrs. Unfrittle, Miss Doolittle.
How do you do? How do you do?
Lord and Lady Boxington, Miss Doolittle.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Have I said something I wouldn't? Not at all, my my dear.
Oh, that's a mercy anyhow. What I always say.
I don't suppose it's the next time before the next race to place a bet. Oh, come, my dear.
I'm afraid not, Colonel.
Oh, I have a bet on number 7.